everyone, welcome back again for the another session of Plant Kingdom. In the previous class we have discussed about the bryophytes. From today's class onwards we are going to initiate with the another concept which is related to the Plant Kingdom, that is the another group of Plant Kingdom which is called as pteridophytes. So what exactly mean by pteridophytes? So if at all we look into that, as we came across certain group of plants like the algae, the bryophytes, and even we came across the classes which are related to the algae, right? It may be a green algae, brown algae, red algae. Then after that we came across the economic importance. Then we are started to discuss about the characteristic feature of bryophytes, then the classification of bryophytes, within which we have discussed about Hepaticopsida, Anthoceropsida and Bryopsida. In other words, liverworts, hornworts and the masses, right? And even we came across the example related to those all the classes, right? So from today's class we'll discuss about, we'll shift on for the pteridophytes. So what exactly mean by pteridophyte? So the pteridophyte, the now if at all we split the word pteridon, pterido, phyta. Phyta means what? As you all know that phyta, which simply means the plants, right? So the pteron, it is actually, it has been given two names, pteron, which means the feathers, and phyta, which means the plants. They are the feather like plants, as because of the presence of their leaves. So their leaves appears to be as the feathers. So for the reason we are going to call them as what? The pteridophytes. So in generally, if at all we are willing to define the pteridophytes are the first completely terrestrial plants. In other words, they are the tracheophytic archegoniate which are the embryophytes without seeds. So if at all we are willing to define it, the pteridophyte are, these are tracheo means what exactly mean by tracheo? Tracheophytic embryonic plants without seeds. So these are the tracheophytic embryonic plants which are without seeds. So they are, in other words, these pteridophytes are first completely terrestrial plants. So here these are the in general they are actually these are commonly known as the botanical snakes, or these are, in other words, there will be one more name, let me recall that. So these are commonly known as, yes, vascular cryptogams. The pteridophytes are commonly known as, these are commonly known as vascular cryptogams or botanical snakes. These are commonly known as vascular cryptogams or botanical snakes. So the, as the name only indicates, split up madide pteron, which means the feather, phyta means the plants. Why actually we are going to call them as the pteridophytes or the feather like plants? Yakappa heltuvappa antandre, it is mainly because of the nature of the leaves. So the leaves appears to be the, especially the leaves of ferns, which are like you can learn that in the morphology, which are pinnately compound leaves. ಲೀಫ್ ಅಂತ ಬಂದಾಗ ನಾವು ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಷಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂತ ಬರ್ತೀವಿ, ಲೈಕ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಲೀವ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಲೀವ್ಸ್. ಕಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಲೀಫ್ನ ಪಾಮೆಡ್ಲಿ ಕಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪಿನ್ನೆಡ್ಲಿ ಕಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಅಂತ ಮತ್ತೆ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಆಗಿ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವು. ಸೊ ದ ಟೆರಿಡೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಪಿನ್ನೆಡ್ಲಿ ಕಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಲೀವ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನೀವು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ನಾವು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ಬೋದಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಹುಂಚಿ ಹಣ್ಣಿನ ಗಿಡ ನೋಡಿರ್ತೀನಿ ನೀವು ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಅದರ ಲೀಫ್ನ ರಿಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊರಿ ಹೆಂಗಿರ್ತದ, ಈ ಟೈಪ್ ಮೈನ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಲೀವ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಓವರ್ ರೈಟ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಈ ಟೈಪ್ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಹೂ ಸಾರಿ ಲೀಫ್ ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಈ ಟೈಪ್ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಲೀಫ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಇಂಥ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟಿಗೆ ನಾವೇನಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪಿನ್ನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಕಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಲೀಫ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಇದು ಹೆಂಗೆ ಅನಿಸ್ತದಪ್ಪ ಅಂತದ ಒಂದ್ಸಾರಿ ನಮಗೆ, ಇಟ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಆಸ್ ಫೆದರ್. ಫೆದರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೇನು, ಪುಚ್ಚ. ಎದುರ್ಗೋ ಒಂದು ಕೋಳಿ ಪುಚ್ಚ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ನೀವು ಅಬ್ಸಲ್ಯೂಟ್ಲಿ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಡವರ್ಕಿ ಒಂದು ಮಿಡ್ರಿಗತೆ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಆಜು ಬಾಜು ಏನಿರ್ತಾವ ಹೇರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಆಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಆಸ್ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಟು ದ ಫೆದರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ರೀಸನ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲೀವ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಫರ್ನ್ಸ್. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಹೆಸರು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವಿಗೆ ಟೆರಿಡೋಫೈಟ್, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಹೆಸರು ಏನಪ್ಪಾ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕೇಸಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ಸ್ ದ ಫರ್ನ್ಸ್ ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಆಸ್ ದ ಫೆದರ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್, ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ರೀಸನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ feather like plants are commonly known as vascular cryptogams. So the name only indicates here, tracheophytic. Tracheophytic means what? There will be a presence of xylem and phloem. So remember, these are the first completely terrestrial vascular plants. What are vascular plants? The plant which bears xylem and phloem. So in lower organisms like in the pteridophytes or in the bryophyte, in the algae, we are not going to find the xylem and phloem, which are the conducting tissues, alva. So conducting tissue like a xylem and phloem were absent in algae as well as in bryophyte. For the first time there will be, because of the course of evolution, there will be the presence of the, you know, the differentiation of the parenchymatous cells into the xylem and the phloem. The complexity is going to vary. In case of pteridophyte, in case of angiosperm, eradunu compare madidaga, angiosperms are having more complex xylem and phloem than that of the pteridophyte. But illa, at least there has been initiated to conduct. There will be a specific tissues that have been developed in the pteridophyte to perform a specific function like conduction of the water, conduction of the food. They might be in a simplified way, they might be in a very simple way, they are not much modified as we are going to observe in the angiosperms. But illa first time development madidu, first time development adu, first time confined adu illa in the members of pteridophyte. Exactly, this is the major, what we are going to call it as the distinguishing character from the algae and the bryophytes. It's a distinguishing character of the pteridophytes compared to the lower plants. So if at all, if you look into the habitat, most of them are terrestrial in nature, remember. So I am not going to write it, I am just writing a ಹಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್. ನೀವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾ ಹೋಮ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಹೇಳಿರ್ತೀನಿ ಬರೀರಿ ಅಂತಂದು ಹೇಳಿ, ಒಬ್ಬೊಬ್ರು ಇಲ್ಲೇನು ಬರ್ದಿರ್ತೀನಲ್ಲ ಅದನ್ನ ಹೋಗಿ ಫೋಟೋ ಕಳಿಸಿರ್ತೀರಿ ನನಗೆ, ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲೇನು ಬರ್ದಿರ್ತೀನಲ್ಲ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಬರೆದು ಕಳಿಸಿರ್ತೀರಿ. ನಾನು ಈಗ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಹೆಂಗಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಗಿವ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದೇ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಆರ್ ಟೆರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಅಂತ ಬರ್ದೆ, ನಾನು ಬರೀ ಟೆರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಅಂತ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಬರ್ದಿರ್ತೀನಿ. ನಾನು ಹಿಂದೆ ಮುಂದೆ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಏನಂತ, ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ಟೆರಿಡೋಫೈಟಿಕ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಲಿವ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಟೆರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಫುಲ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ನಾ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದು. ಬರೀ ಕೀ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ನೀವೇನ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತೀರಿ ಟೆರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಅಂತ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಬರ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತೀರಿ, ಹಿಂದೆ ಮುಂದಲ್ಲೂ ದೇವ್ರು ಬಿಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತೀರಿ, ಹೌದಾ? ಸೊ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡೂ ಸಚ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಹೌದಾ? ಬರೀ ಇಷ್ಟೇ ಬರೆದ್ರಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಆಗಂಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ನೋ, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಲೈಕ್ ನಾ ಹೌ ಟು ಫ್ರೇಮ್ ದ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್. ಬರೀ ನಾ ಎಲ್ಲ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಪೂನ್ ಫೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಆತಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ವೈಟ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್. ಬರೀ ಬೈ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಹಾಕಿದ್ರೆ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಂಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ಸೊ ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕೀ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೊ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟೆರಿಡೋಫೈಟಿಕ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗ್ರೋ ಇನ್ ದ ಟೆರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಲೀಡ್ ದರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಟೆರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಶೇಡಿ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಇನ್ ಅದರ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಮೇ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಶೇಡ್ಸ್. ದೇ ಲವ್ ಶೇಡ್ಸ್. ನೆರಳಾಶ್ರಿತ ಪ್ರದೇಶದೊಳಗೆ ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಟೆರಿಡೋಫೈಟು ಗ್ರೋ ಆಗ್ತಾವು. ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಅಜೋಲಾ ಮಾರ್ಸಿಲಿಯಾ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಮೈಟ್ ಬಿ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಅಕ್ವಾಟಿಕ್ ರೀಸನ್ ಅಕ್ವಾಟಿಕ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟಾಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ. ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅಜೋಲಾ ಮಾರ್ಸಿಲಿಯಾ. These are the members of pteridophyte found in the aquatic region. Azola, LLA. Then there are certain members, they are also going to grow over the other plants. So like Selaginella, Lycopodium. So there are certain members which are epiphytic in nature. Epi means above, phytic means plants. They are going to grow as epiphytes like Selaginella. Right, Selaginella species, there is a species, and Lycopodium, there is a species which is comes under Lycopodium genus, Lycopodium plagmaria. Lycopodium plagmaria is a one such type of species. Lead their life, they are going to grow over the other plant. We call such plants as what? Epiphytic plant. Epi andra above, phyte means plant. So the pteridophytes grow over the other plants, other, you know, like a bark of the individual branches of the plants. Alle we are going to find certain members, so we are going to find epiphytic things as well. There are certain plants like a Selaginella, Lepidophylla, which is acting as a xerophyte. So the xerophyte antandre the type of plant which will grow in a scarcity of water, elle like a desert condition antandage xerophytic antandre andre enappa andre elle neerina availability kadme irutado anta pradeshadolage belitakkanta plants ge naave enanta helthivi we are going to call them as xerophytic plants, the type of plant which used to grow in a less availability of the water, the area which is with very less amount of water. In such areas, if the plants are going to succeed to grow over that place, we call such plants as what? The xerophytes. There is a species called as Selaginella lepidophylla. Selaginella lepidophylla. This species, it will grow in a as a xerophyte, which is where there will be a scarcity of water. So if at all ivage enaita pandre ell grow aagthadu anta gottaayit namage. If at all we shift for the actual concept, life cycle bagge bandvappa antandre, as we all know that the dominant phase in case of a bryophyte is, the dominant phase in case of bryophyte is ಗ್ಯಾಮೆಟೋಫೈಟ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ನಾವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡ ಕಲ್ತಿದ್ದೀವಿ, ನಾವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡ ಇದು ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದೀವಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್ ದ ಡಾಮಿನೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ಟೆರಿಡೋಫೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್. It is important for NEET examination. So it is very very important for competitive examination. Remember this, the dominant phase in case of pteridophyte is the sporophyte. So if at all we look into the sporophyte is independent herbaceous, right? So the sporophyte can be differentiated into root, stem and the leaves. Clear? Remember, the sporophyte is independent herbaceous, right? Independent means what? It is not at all depending on any of the organism. It is not depending even on the gametophyte as well. So remember, in case of here, the sporophyte, it has the independent, it has the capacity of absorption of the water as well as it has the capacity of preparing their own food material ಅಂದಂಗೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ರೆವೋಫೈಟ್ ಹಂಗಾಗಿತ್ತು ದ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಷಿಯಲಿ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಗ್ಯಾಮೆಟೋಫೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ರೆವೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ ನಾನು ಡೈಗ್ರಾಮ್ ತೆಗೆದಿದ್ದೆ ಫಿಲೇರಿಯಾದ್ದು ಈ ಟೈಪ್ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತ ಒಂದು ಡೈಗ್ರಾಮ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕಾಲ್ ದಮ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಗ್ಯಾಮೆಟೋಫೈಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ವಿ ನಾವು ಅಲ್ವಾ ಸೊ ಸಾರಿ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ವಿ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಷಿಯಲಿ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮೆಟೋಫೈಟ್ ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಡೋಫೈಟ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹರ್ಬೇಷಿಯಸ್ ಸೊ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಶಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು It can be differentiated into root, stem, and leaves. Notice it is a very, very unique character. In case of bryophyte, thus plant body is not going to be differentiated. We are going to call such a part of the plant body as what? Now we are going to say thallus. So, all root like, stem like, leaf like structures in the mosses. In the funaria. But in case of here, we are directly differentiating the sporophyte into root system, shoot system. Right? So, root, stem, and the leaves and then really characteristically we are differentiating the plant body. And if at all we look into that, the sporophyte has adventitious types of root. The sporophyte has adventitious type of root. I hope you all are familiar with the types of root. Right? There are two major types of root as you have learned in the lower classes. One though, tap root, inandu adventitious root. Kaltiri anukondidina. Right? ಒಂದು ಟ್ಯಾಪ್ ರೂಟ್ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಅಡ್ವೆಂಟೀಶಿಯಸ್ ರೂಟ್ ನಿಮಗೆ ಅಡ್ವೆಂಟೀಶಿಯಸ್ ರೂಟ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ಬದಲಿ ಫೈಬ್ರಸ್ ರೂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕಲಿಸಿರಬಹುದು ಪ್ರಾಬಬ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಲೋವರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರೂಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ಯಾಪ್ ರೂಟ್ ಅನದರ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಡ್ವೆಂಟೀಶಿಯಸ್ ರೂಟ್ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೋರೋಫೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟೈಡೋಫೈಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರೂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅಡ್ವೆಂಟೀಶಿಯಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ರೂಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಸಾಲ್ವಿನಿಯಾ ಸಾಲ್ವಿನಿಯಾ ಅನ್ನೋದ್ರೊಳಗೆ ರೂಟ್ ಇರಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹೈಯರ್ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ In Salvinia, it lacks roots. Salvinia lacks roots. It does not having any roots. Clear? So I am not going to write it. Salvinia because new one carnal rubber ko hone na pili lan thamar. Salvinia, which belongs to the pteridophyte, it does not having any root. Stem is sometime if at all. Now root bagi matadve root to yau type irta thare. Adventitious types of root irta thare, right? So the stem is aerial or underground. So if at all it is aerial, like it may be erect or prostrate. So if at all we look into the stem, stem is aerial or underground. If at all it is underground, there will be a technical term. If at all it is underground, we are going to call that aspect as rhizome. ನಾವೆಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ಬೋದಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸೇಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರೈಸೋಮ್ ಅಂತ ಬಂದಾಗ ಜಿಂಜರ್ ನೋಡಿ ಲೈಕ್ ಜಿಂಜರ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಹಸಿ ಶುಂಠಿ ಅಲ್ಲ ನಾಟ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್ ದ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿಲ್ ಆಡ್ ಟು ದ ಟೀ ಆರ್ ಫ್ಲೇವರಿಂಗ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಗೆ ಜಿಂಜಿಬಿರೇಸಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ ಅದು ಜಿಂಜಿಬಿರೇಸಿ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಆ ಜಿಂಜರ್ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ದಟ್ ಜಿಂಜರ್ ಶುಂಠಿ ಹಸಿ ಶುಂಠಿ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರೈಸೋಮ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗ್ತದ ಅದು ಗಿಡದ ಮೇಲೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತದೆ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಜೋಗ ಬಿದ್ದಿರ್ತವೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಇರ್ತದ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಲೋ ದ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ರೈಸೋಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಅದೇ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ವೇದ ಒಳಗೆ ಟೆರಿಡೋಫೈಟು ಕೂಡ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಏನಾರ ಅಂಡರ್ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗಿರ್ತದ ಯಾವ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಆಗ್ತದ ದ ರೈಸೋಮ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಇಫ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಏರಿಯಲ್ ದ ಏರಿಯಲ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೋಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಏರಿಯಲ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೋಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಶೋ dichotomous branching. It is going to prostrate and show dichotomous branching. It will show that means what in short way we are going to call the aspect as the stem is dichotomously branched antanthu heli clear aagi naavu en maadabodu helabodu it is dichotomously branched antanthu heli we can distinguish it. So and along with that if at all we look into the leaves anta bandaga so yenaitu stemin bagge maatadidivi naavu root in bagge maatadidivi naavu stemin bagge maatadidivi naavu if at all it comes to the leaf as because the sporophyte has all the three types right it is having the root it is having the stem it is having the leaves so we have discussed about how exactly the root is how type of root irthada adventitious type of root irthada how exactly the stem is it may be aerial or it may be underground if at all it is aerial it is erect then prostrate or prostrate then it is going to show a dichotomous branches so that means what it is going to have a branches which is it is not like a the sugar cane it is not like and then just for the understanding I am giving an example of angiosperms comparison you nodirthiravna you inta organisms na neevu nodirangilla so adu nodana helibodabodu neevu right so if at all we look into that leaves the leaves are two types it may be the microphyllous or it may be the macrophyllous so if at all we look into that the leaves are of two types in general right the leaves are of two types it is microphyllous that means what micro means what minute small phyllous means what leaves so the small leaves antanagi in general we are going to call them as the small leaves then it may be the macrophyllous that means what the larger leaves the leaves are larger antanagi so we are going to there are certain examples related to that in the certain members like Lycopodium, Selaginella, Equisita, we are going to find the micro leaves or microphyllous leaves. Ella in the Selaginella, Lycopodium, Equisita, we are going to find microphyllous type of leaf in the member like ferns in the member like ferns we are going to find the macrophyllous type of leaves in the member of ferns in ferns we are going to find the macrophyllous type of leaves like the adiantum there is a species called as adiantum not getting the scientific name it is also not here adiantum candidum yeah adiantum candidum antakanta one species ada that is referred to as walking fern adike enanta heltiva pa andre walking fern anta heltivi you can write it as the macrophyllous like adiantum neevu internet olaga adiantum species anta hodare you will get this beautiful structure adiantum so if at all I am having that picture I am going to send you I have clicked a pic which is very beautiful one so adiantum species right so that is how we can differentiate the sporophyte the individual type yakappa adakke walking fern anta heltivappa antandre the leaf of that particular adiantum has the adventitious bud which upon contact with the soil it will gives rise to a new plant right so adra leaf ina tuttudige adventitious buds irtavo soil ge reach aad takshana al germination aagtada mattom plant belutada matte adra leaf mattom kade join eno soil ge reach aad takshana mattom plant belutada that's how they are going to walk over the soil so for that reason the adiantum is referred to be as a walking fern this question has been asked for several time in a higher competitive examination yen anta helthi naavu idakke adiantum popularly known as what walking fern remember this it is popularly known as walking fern as because the leaf of that particular adiantum has the adventitious bud. If at all that adventitious or the leaf touches the soil, it will germinate and gives this to a new plant. So that's how it will travel, that's how it is going to walk over the soil. So for that reason, it is, we are going to call that aspect as what? The walking fern. Clear? So the leaf traces do not, if at all in case of now Macrophyllus anta nodidaga, they are going to have a parenchymatous leaf gap, which is especially for the vascular cylinder and all. If at all we discussed some of the concept, if again I have morphological features na nodid now. If at all we move on for the further aspects like the vascular aspects, like how exactly the stem is, how exactly their things are going to be, like they are going to be there here.